about the history of Orange Field sports, particularly basketball?
Well, not a whole lot of history over the years with basketball. I mean, of course, you know, they're fortunate this year. There were some fantastic games here in Bobcat Gym, some like we haven't seen before. And then not only were Orangeville people here, but opposing fans, of course, came to watch as well. And people that didn't care about either team, but they wanted to see what Valcat was all about.
Val, of course, way out by the free throw line. Now he'll try to. He's going to want to shoot the good. Now Wagner wants to drive. Throws it over. Oh, and it's the big Cat with the lay-in. Cat in the paint. Pre-Gene underneath to the big Cat off the glass and good for two. All the way. Wants to go coast to coast, but he missed the layup. There's the big dunk by Val Cat. His first one.
He has the highest upside of any kid I've ever coached, yeah. And the most athletic.
The undeniable impact of players from Africa. Success stories abound, yet those, sadly, are exceptions. First spotted on African playgrounds, sometimes simply for their height, are brought to the U.S. only to be victimized.
As a coach, you identify size. So when you see that size, you want to see if they can, you know, if they can play. And I think that's what happens. Some of these guys are not ready. A lot of people don't invest in them. And I've seen a lot of kids move around, and then you can't find them anymore.
He was kind of on his own, living in a motel with many other high school kids that were his teammates.
It was actually two other African kids, I think from the Congo. And I remember getting a call from Valentine, can you come get me? I knew that I was coming to get him and like all his things.
There's nothing free in this.
I want to make sure we understand that. We got to go dig. The ball go up, we need a board.
I guarantee you they're going to come and wrestle you, but we still going to grind that ball. It's going to be a tight game. It's going to be tough. Be prepared for that. We're just going to grind.
Play soccer when I was 3 years old, and I stopped when I was 12 because my brother say like soccer won't help me because everybody play soccer in over there. So he say I have to go play something else. So they say because you're so tall, you have to go play basketball.
The African players seem to be, you know, bigger. Athletic. And most of these kids probably, they might even grew up on a rim with no nets and you know, dirt court. But they've all been very loyal. They've been very committed, outstanding students. And they've all come to this country for an opportunity to play basketball.
The American dream.
American dream? LeBron James, locked by Embiid. Go to the league, play pro basketball. That's what I want. That's my American dream. I mean, I'm not worried. I feel like it's gonna work out. I mean, I give everything to God, you know, so I don't worry. I know he will never let me down.
Val came over to the United States to a prep school in Washington, D.C., bounced around, stayed in North Carolina for a while, ended up in Houston.
These kids end up with their suitcases, you know, outside, and they get stuck in a hotel room, and they're not being fed. Anyway, he asked Angelique and I, can I stay here for now, for the time being? And as far as she and I were concerned, we were just going to give him a place to stay until we could find a family to take care of him and that is willing to adopt a child. But that never came to pass.
Yeah.
These kids are kids, you know. They might play basketball, but at the end of the day, they're trying to make something of their lives. And if she and I can help, then that's what we're going to do. And we've done that for years. So Angelique says in May, let's do it. And then it was early July when the adoption was granted.
That was a dream that day, because I never believed something like that would happen to me. I never ever think about something like that.
Our lives really haven't, I mean, I always have a house full of children, so it's like, it was no different than when I had a bunch of Orangefield kids over here, right? You know, and sometimes I had both Orangefield kids and basketball kids, and so, made a lot of hot dogs.
Back out to the court, Barbers Hill High School. Again, this time the 3A area round contest. Orangefield taking on Van Vleck. Bobcats off to the races right out of the gate. Feast your eyes on this. Valentin Cat here climbing up, getting the rebound in the flush.
Under the Texas UIL rules, you can't turn 19 before September 1st and be eligible to play sports. So he is 2 weeks too old to play high school basketball in Texas this year. So we're in the process of finding him a school to go to next year, and we've been contacted by several schools.
Hey, Coach, it's Michael Cat. Just got your message. Sorry, I had my phone off the charger about Valentine.
We have opportunity, and you know, when we're recruiting, we want a kid that wants to have confidence in himself and wants to work and make a difference and be impactful, and that's what we're looking for a special kid like that.
You know, I know he's got a lot of schools that are looking at him, and as tall as he is, I guess the sky's the limit, you know, for the guy. I mean, he's a fantastic player, and I can't wait to see what's going to happen.
He's got so many tools, you know, as far as athleticism goes. I don't think I would want to put a ceiling on him. I think that there's no telling.
Val's story, although not unique in a lot of respects, I mean, he's not the first or the last kid that came over for whatever reason. The people who brought him over aren't the people that ended up helping him. I think his story is unique in a lot of respects in that I think he ended up where he was supposed to end up, and that's where he is today.
They're playing basketball.